Hello and welcome everyone. I hope you all are fine at your homes. So now let's start with the video. In this video, we have to revise our chapter Force and Energy because we already discussed this chapter in our online classes. So in this video, we are gonna do the important words and the checkpoints in the chapter and then the touchdown of the chapter, and then we will move on to the exercise questions. So the chapter name is Force and Energy. So what is force? Push or pull acting on an object is called force. I will tell the main headings. The type of force is muscular force, frictional force, then we have gravitational force, buoyant force, elastic force, mechanical force, magnetic force. These are the type of forces. We already discussed these. Now the checkpoint first. We have fill in the blanks. Force exert upward. Thrust. And this is buoyant force. So buoyant force which push anything in upward direction, and it is basically exerted or mainly exerted by the liquids like your water. The ship will float in the water by end force. Second one is the dash is the force applied when there is physical contact. So in physical contact it's a mechanical force. Mechanical force applied when there is a physical contact. So next is simple machine. The machine which makes our work easier are called simple machine. Its type lever. Lever again classified into first class, second class, third class lever. Then we have inclined planes. Then we have screw, simple machine. Screw are in bottles. Lid of a toothpaste. Screw to tighten the things. Wedge, V shape, inclined planes. Join together to create a wedge. Wheel and axle, pulley. There are two types, fixed pulley and movable pulley. This is also a simple machine. Then checkpoint, tick the correct option. This is very good. One, pulley slash screw help change the direction of the force. So pulley help to change the direction of force. Second one, screw inclined planes are used ramp for wheelchair. So inclined planes are used as a ramp for wheelchair. Fixed and movable pulley is used in well and boil to draw water. So in wells we use fixed pulley is the correct answer. Carpenters prefer nails screw to hold things together. They prefer screw. Screw is the best option for a carpenter to hold things together. Then we have energy. Energy is the ability to do work. Again, types of energy: solar energy, light energy, heat energy, wind energy, hydel. Then we have sound energy and electric energy. Some another form also is the mechanical energy based on the movement of the body and the position of the body. Kinetic energy when object is in movement or in motion. Potential energy when object is at a position. Geothermal, the heat energy which we get from the interior of the earth, and it is also used to generate electricity. Renewable, non-renewable. Renewables which we can replenish over time, means we can use them again and again after some time. But non-renewable, the energy that we get from coal and petroleum which cannot be replenished if they get over. They take so much time to form again. Then this checkpoint we have matched the following. Enable us to see things, light energy. let me do in another way. Light energy help us to see things. Interior of the earth, that is geothermal energy. Then microwave, it run on electric energy. Flowing water, hydel energy we get from the water. Flowing water. A moving train, moving object possess kinetic energy. Then the law of conservation of energy. It is very important topic and you have to learn the definition and understand also that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can only change from one form to another. So energy can neither be created means we cannot create any type of energy and we cannot destroy any type of energy. It only change from one form to another. Like hydel energy, we built dams and we use that energy to generate electric energy. This is the basic example. Then the important words we have: machine, a device which help us to do work with less effort, or machine which makes our work easier. Then lever, a simple machine in the form of rod that can turn around a fixed point is definition of lever. If I will show you, this is a plane, this is a fixed point, here we will apply force and here will be the load. Or the seesaw in the parks, here is the fixed point, it will turn around fixed point, is called lever. So it is a simple machine. Fulcrum, the fixed point. What is fulcrum? The fixed point around which, about which a lever moves. Load, the weight that we try to move with the help of lever. Effort, the force apply is called effort. Then inclined plane, a sloping surface. In inclined planes, what will happen? One side is up on a height and one is lower side. This is inclined plane. Then next we have pulley, a wheel with a grooved rim around which a rope is passed is pulley. Screw, an inclined plane wrapped around a cylinder. These all are simple machine. Wedge, two inclined planes that meet to form a sharp edge. When two inclined plane, one first plane and second plane, they form a V shape and this part is sharp. So two inclined planes that meet to form a sharp edge is called wedge. Renewable energy, the energy that can replenish over a period of time is renewable, means we can use that again. Non-renewable, that energy, the energy that cannot be replenished over time, or it will take much more time than the renewable energy sources. Then next we have touchdown of the chapter name force and energy. First, force, its type. These are the types: muscular, frictional, gravitational, magnetic force, buoyant force, mechanical force, elastic force. Then energy, we have solar, mechanical, geothermal, heat energy, light energy, electric energy. Again it divide into renewable and non-renewable. In these, renewable energy are solar, wind, hydel, and non-renewable are geothermal, electric energy, also renewable, we can again produce them. Then the sources of energy are, or natural sources are, solar, wind and water. Then simple machine, we have one more topic in this chapter, simple machine that makes our work easier, or we have to use less effort to do the work. Again, inclined planes, screw, wedges, lever, pulley, wheel and axle, again lever, Liver again classified into first class, second class and third class. You all know the difference between each one. Now we have the exercise question. So the first one, take the correct option and fill in the blanks. So you have to fill by yourself. I am only going to tell the answer. A spoon used to open a tin can act as a lever, because in that one is fixed point, fulcrum, on one side we are applying effort, or force apply is called effort. So screw is the right answer. The force that is used on a lever is called effort. Load, the weight we are lifting. Load is the weight we are lifting. Fulcrum is the fixed point. Effort is the force apply on a lever. So the third one we have, a bottle opener is an example of that is second class lever. What is second class lever? In this is lever. Here we will apply the force or effort, and this will be the fixed point or fulcrum, and load will be the in center, which we have to lift, or in that case we have to open the lid of the bottle cap. So this is second class lever, in which load will be placed in the center. Then fourth one, wrapped act as a or an a ramp is a inclined plane. So this is correct option. Inclined planes means like this. One end is at high position and one is at low position. Then fifth, an example of a third class lever is, what is third class lever? In a third class lever, the force is in the center. Here will be the force. Here will be the fixed point. And here will be the load or weight. Force. Center mein kya hoga aapka? Force. Here will be the force and fixed point will be the in end. So the pair of tweezer is a third class lever. Now we have next part, fill in the blanks. So the upward force exerted by the water pushes an object is called buoyant force. Upward force by a liquid is called buoyant force. The second one, a screw is an inclined plane wrapped around a cylinder. What is the shape of a screw? We have a cylinder and around it there is a wrap of the inclined plane. So this is an example of screw. On top there is head of the screw, and here will be the inclined planes are wrapped, and it is like sharp in the bottom. So the inside part is a cylinder. The next, a wedge is a double inclined plane. Wedge is a double inclined plane, first plane, second plane. Then fourth one, dash make it hard to slide a heavy object across the surface. So frictional force makes it hard to slide a heavy object. Fifth one, dash pulley is used to draw water from the well. So in well we use a fixed pulley, like this is downside the well, we place a rod, and on this rod we place a pulley, round pulley with grooves inside, and then we drop a rope over the pulley into the well with a bucket. So this is a type of fixed pulley. Then sixth one, dash is the main source of light on the earth. On earth we get light from the sun. So sun is the main source on earth of light on earth. So next we have C part, short answer question. Give two examples where screw is used. So in your bottle cap we use screw, and another example you can give in the lid of a toothpaste we also use screw, and another example you can give from your daily life. It is up to you. You can think of any example and you can write. Then second one, define load, effort and fulcrum with respect to a lever. So what is load? The weight we have to lift. Fulcrum, the fixed point. Then effort, the force apply. Is called effort and it is denoted by capital E. The next we have to define simple machine. A machine which makes our work easier or we have to use less effort is called simple machine. So the name six type. We have pulley, screw, wheel and axle, wedge, inclined plane and levers. Then name three sources of energy in nature. We have wind, water and sun or heat energy. So these are the source of energy present in nature. Then fifth one, we have state the law of conservation of energy. This is very good and important question. What is law of energy? Conservation of energy, that energy can neither be created and nor be destroyed. It can only change from one form to another. Like heat energy can change into electric energy by using solar plates. So we cannot create or destroy energy, we can only change from one form to another. Then we have D part, differentiate between the following. First class lever and second class lever. So we can give example also and their definition also. In first class lever we have fulcrum at the center, and in second class we have load at the center. I will put bucket like it is load, and this is fixed point fulcrum. So this is one difference. In first class we have fulcrum at the center, fixed point. In second class we have load at the center. And in first class we have seesaw in the parks example, and in this bottle opener, like this type bottle opener is the example. Then we have fixed pulley and movable pulley. So now we have the difference between fixed pulley and movable pulley. So fixed pulley, it will change the direction of force. Like we will pull the bucket right from the downside, and we will pull like this. This is pink color is rope. This is your pulley. So when we apply the force, means our direction is changing. So first fixed pulley, what it will do, it will change the direction of force. It is used in welds. So example is in welds. So movable pulley, this pulley is used to pick up load from one place to another place. Like this is load, it will move like in this direction also and in this direction also. In cranes, movable pulley we use in cranes. So these are the example: fixed pulley in welds, movable pulley in weightlifting cranes. Muscular force and elastic force. So the muscular force in which we use muscles of our body, in elastic force we use springs or rubber band. Suppose if I have a spring, if I pull it from both sides in this direction and in this direction, it will stretch out, but when we leave it or when we release it, it will again regain its original shape up to that much. So this is elastic force. In this, no use of muscles, it is purely based on the spring property or the rubber band property. Then next we have hydel energy and solar energy. In hydel energy we use water, flowing water, to produce some another type of energy like electric energy. In solar energy we get energy from the sun. We use solar energy to cook food, to heat something, like in solar cooker. Then the fifth one, we have renewable and non-renewable. Renewable energy which can be replenished or reused after some period of time. Non-renewable which cannot be replenished over a small period of time. It takes so many years, thousands of years, to again create or replenish. Renewable energy, solar energy, wind energy, hydel energy, non-renewable energy के examples हैं आपके coal, petroleum और every petroleum product is non-renewable energy sources. Then we have long answer question. What is frictional force? What are its advantage and disadvantage? Frictional force is used to stop or slow down a moving object. It is between two surfaces. What is advantage? So frictional force is has many advantage. We use frictional force in walking. When we walk on a floor, we use the frictional force between our foot and floor. Disadvantage, it produces heat, it breaks down things, wear and tear the machine parts. So that's why sometimes we do not need frictional force. We need very less frictional force to protect our machines from wear and tear, to increase their lifetime. Then define mechanical energy. What are its two type? Give example. So mechanical energy, the energy associated with the movement and position of the object is called mechanical energy. Again, movement of the object, it is moving or in rest. Then position of the object, there are two types: kinetic energy, when object is moving it has kinetic energy, when object is at a position then it has potential energy. PE and KE. KE kinetic energy, PE is potential energy. Then give example. A moving train is an example of kinetic energy. A rock present on a roof or on a mountain is a potential energy, because first it is present on ground, but then we place the rock on a top of a building, so it has a potential energy. There is a change in the position. Then write a short note on buoyant force. Buoyant force, the force which is applied by the liquid in the upward direction. So example of buoyant force are the boat which float in the water, the hot air balloon. They all are the example of buoyant force, but we have to write a short note. So the upward force exerted by the liquid is called buoyant force. Air is also exert the buoyant force. This also you can write. This help hot air balloon to rise into air. Then we have, now we have high order thinking skill question. The first one, why is heat produced when we rub our hands together? So when you rub the hand together, means two surfaces are in contact. One hand and second hand, when we rub them, the two surfaces are in contact, means there is frictional force. There is frictional force, and what frictional force do? It produces the heat. That's why machine are face the wear and tear of their parts. So why heat is produced? Due to the frictional force between the palm of our hand or the surface of our hand which are in contact. Then complex machine are made up of simple machine. Discuss. So take any one complex machine like your car, your bicycle, your bike. They all are complex machine. Or you can take example of washing machine. So they are asking, there are multiple simple machine present in a complex machine. So this is your bicycle. Here you are using tire, wheel and axle. This is axle in the center. This is wheel and axle you are using. We are using lever also. In your handle you are applying effort. So this is the example. We are using so many simple machine to create a complete complex machine. To make a complex machine, we are using simple machine. You can give example by yourself also. Then next we have value and life skill based question. Jimmy Dad get his car engine and other parts cleaned at a mechanic shop once every few months. Why do you think he does that? Why should we take care of our machine? So it is for you. Why we go to a mechanic shop to repair our cars or to get the service of our vehicle? Why do you think ki why we are going to mechanic shop and why should we take care of our machine? So we should take care of our machine to increase their lifetime. If I will not go on a mechanic shop with my car, it will only work for few years. But if I will go on mechanic shop and repair it again and again, then it can work for many years. That's why we should take care of our machine. But this answer you have to do by yourself. Why do you think he does that? Why he go on a mechanic shop once every few months? After few months, he definitely go on a mechanic shop to repair his car engine. So I hope all topics are clear in this chapter and question from the exercise. And thanks for watching.